We have downloaded the linux.iso file, we've checked the MD5 code to prove that it's correct, and we tried to create the DVD, but it did not work on my Windows XP computer. To get around the DVD problem, we're going to put the image on a flash drive and then boot into it to test it out without changing anything on the computer's hard drive. We're going to need to download a program to do this, and for that, I'm going to pendrivelinux.com. Right here at the top of their page, they've got popular Yummy and popular Universal USB Installer. I'm going to choose the Universal USB Installer and click that. Right here it has at the top of the page that we're on the USB Installer, easy as 1, 2, 3. We've got some screenshots of what it should look like, and then when it runs, and right down at the bottom, we even have a download. I will click to download the UUI or Universal USB Installer, save file, and here it is in my download folder. I will double click to open up the Universal USB Installer, run, and notice we will need to have administrative rights to run this. The first thing that it's asking me for is a distribution. We are going to install Linux Mint, so I'm choosing that. Now it's asking us where the ISO file is. I'm going to browse and select my ISO file from the download folder. It's asking us what drive do we want to place this on. When I click the drop-down button, it shows us we can put it on A or E. We don't see the C drive because we don't have this checkbox checked. This will show us all the drives, but I only want to see the flash drive so I don't accidentally wipe out something on that hard drive. I'm going to choose format, and I also have this option of setting a persistent file size. This is asking us if we want to set up a little memory so that we can store and hold some changes to downloads in memory on the flash drive. Right now, it's set to 0. What that means is it will act exactly like a read-only DVD. When we are testing this, we can go into the Software Center, download a program or two, change the background picture, but once we shut down the computer, those programs and changes are gone. When we boot into this the next time, it will boot in exactly like it looked the first time we powered it up. If we updated a file online or a document on a different flash drive, those changes will stay, but the Linux distro itself will not be updated. It will be the same on every boot, just like it would for a read-only DVD. That would be different if we add some persistent memory. Depending on the operating system and the amount of memory on the flash drive, you may be able to add a persistent file. If you do, you'll be able to save the changes you made to your desktop and the programs you downloaded from the Software Center. With a non-persistent version, all those changes will be lost when the machine is powered off. Just a quick word about persistent Linux Mint flash drives. They are good for some things, but Linux will run much slower from a flash drive, and you're still limited with what you can do from a flash drive. In other words, not every program will run on a Linux Mint flash drive. It really wasn't meant to be a carrier operating system on a flash drive version of Linux. Linux Puppy, on the other hand, was created exactly for this reason. If you're looking for a flash drive portable version of Linux, check out Linux Puppy. They even have a version that's encrypted. But beware, the more you put on the operating system, the longer the startup and shutdown time will be. It takes some time to put the operating system and all your programs and files into memory. I am not going to add a persistent file. I will leave that 0 and click Create. Everything looks correct to me. I will click Yes. And it's creating our flash drive. Now, while that's running, I want to take a look at some other things here on the pendrivelinux.com website. This is pendrivelinux.com/tag/live-linux-usb. These are some other versions of USB creators. Looking down, we've got XBoot, a multi-boot ISO USB creator. Yummy, another multi-boot USB creator. Sardu, this one also has some essential utilities, antivirus, and some other things to help you repair a Windows XP or Windows 7 operating system. unetbootin, create a Linux USB from Linux. Then we've got multi-system here, Linux Live USB, also known as Lili. And unetbootin, create a live USB from Windows. So there's a lot of other options out there as well. I have used Lili, that works well. I've tried Yummy and XBoot. The ones I've tried work well, so I'm guessing that they would all work well. Mostly, it's just a matter of preference. Let's see how our download is going. We're a little more than halfway. I will speed up the video a little bit. Our installation is complete. And in the next video, we're going to boot into our live version of Linux.